Hi guys!
In this video, the spotlight goes to Tillandsia Usneoides, or better known as Spanish moss. Well, actually it has a lot of names, but yeah. Airplane profile. Tillandsia Usneoides is an epiphytic plant. That means it is nonparasitic, it is supported by another plant, and has aerial roots exposed to the humid atmosphere. It often grows upon larger trees in tropical and subtropical climates. It goes by a lot of names such as Spanish moss, old man's beard, Spanish beard, tree hair, callus hair, and so on. Here are fun facts about its namesake though. The term Usneoides means resembling Usnea, but then again, it is not a lichen like Usnea. I'm not going to elaborate on that. I cannot. Spanish moss was given its name by French explorers. However, it is not native to Spain and is not even a moss. Get that. Instead, it is a flowering plant in the family Bromeliaceae, the bromeliads, just like pineapples, and of course the rest of our air plant friends. It is found in southern North America, the West Indies, and Central and South America. This plant does not require soil. In its native habitat, it winds itself around tall trees and branches. It is a fast grower that can reach lengths of 20 to 25 feet. Tillandsia Usneoides is a flowering plant. It usually has yellow flowers, which appears rarely, are stalkless, have 3 petals and 3 sepals, and usually grow singly. When my Spanish moss bloomed, however, it gave me light cream colored flowers. They were beautiful and cute and little. There are various types of Spanish moss. Tillandsia Usneoides, Monroe's filiformis, also known as silver ghost or el finito. It is a natural form of Spanish moss with very fine green leaves and produces greenish flowers. Tillandsia Usneoides morisis robusta. It is a thicker form of Spanish moss which is green-gray in color unless when wet. It blooms yellows or yellow-green colored flowers. Tillandsia Usneoides odens genuina. I don't really know how it's pronounced. It is another natural form of Spanish moss with brown rather than green or yellow petals when it blooms. I haven't seen any of this yet. Tillandsia Usneoides Spanish gold. This Spanish moss is known for its brilliant yellow tiny flowers and slender gray-green foliage. Foliage. Tillandsia Usneoides tight and curly. When you see it, you'll recognize it. It's tight and curly. Slender silver leaves that curl tightly together are its hallmark. Cute. Tillandsia Kimberley. This is a hybrid between Tillandsia Usneoides and Tillandsia recurvata. Tillandsia Kimberley has long, thin, silver leaves which trail down to form a wispy clump. The plant's flowers are fragrant and form on the end of a long stem. Tillandsia Old Man's Gold. Okay, so this is an interesting hybrid of Tillandsia crocata, you know, an air plant with sweetly scented yellow flowers, and Tillandsia Usneoides, which is also known as the old man's beard. That's how it got the name old man's gold. Catch the drift? Tillandsia Nesli. This hybrid between Tillandsia Usneoides and Tillandsia Malimuntiae, I'm not sure how it's pronounced either, has silvery foliage and blooms gorgeous light purple flowers. In the wild, Tillandsia Usneoides grows hanging from tree branches in full sun through partial shade. But then again, and taking care of them, indirect lighting is strongly suggested to prevent them from, you know, drying out, especially when indoors. Well, as you all know, I keep and take care of all my air plants indoors. So, place my Tillandsia usneoides near the window, but then I transferred it as soon as I realized that it's getting crispy due to the rays of the sun reflecting through the window, I mean through the glass of the window, especially during summer. So if I were you, you should place Spanish moss in the bright light of an east or west facing window. Just make sure the plant is just outside the reach of direct sunlight in the summer, especially in the summer. It is also better to place it a slight distance from a window, such as a dining table or like what I did here. Tillandsia usneoides can thrive in temperatures within 10 to 30 degrees Celsius. Maintain temperatures close to 26 degrees Celsius in spring, summer, and fall. Reduce temperatures to 15 degrees Celsius in winter to encourage the plant to take a rest break. Water. Like other air plants, Spanish moss also has trichomes. So these hair-like scales that cover the whole plant absorb water from the air. It likes water and humidity, but also like other air plants, too much water can cause it to rot. It is really advisable to use rainwater. However, for those of you guys out there who don't have access to rainwater like me, you can use tap water. But just make sure to let it stay overnight in a container. Too much chlorine is a major problem for this plant and may kill it. Trust me, because it blocks its trichomes. Fertilizing. Spanish moss doesn't necessarily need fertilizers to thrive, but then if you want it to grow faster and produce more flowers and get all the needed nutrients it may need, then using a fertilizer would be a way to go. Just make sure not to use too much to avoid fertilizer burn, which would eventually kill your air plants. Personally, I use Hochwertiges Orchideen und Tillandsien Dünger Konzentrat. That's German for high quality orchids and Tillandsia fertilizer concentrate. It's this one. See? It's a German product from Dutra Pflanzen. I have been using this for months now, and as you can see on my post, my plants are healthy, thriving, and reaching milestones. So this is not a sponsored video. So no tea, no shade, no pink lemonade. I'm happy with this product. I included the link in the descriptions down below, just in case you want to check it out and have yours. Have yours too. Propagation. Spanish moss can often be cultivated by offshoots or pups, but unlike other air plants, it would be really hard to notice which ones are the pups. However, you can simply trim off one of the side shoots and start treating it as if it were a new plant, and most of the time it will flourish on its own. In its habitat, parts of Spanish moss just either fall off or carried away by the wind or birds. Then they just grow and thrive from there. You can also grow Spanish moss from seed. It has hair-like seeds like dandelions, and if you're patient enough to undergo the long process, then you might also give it a try. So just another side note, the tank top that I'm wearing right now is actually from the Great North. They are a Canadian company, which goal is to provide awesome quality apparel that feels great to wear, and we're also promoting an environmentally friendly future for us all to share. So if you purchase an item from them, 10% of that profit goes directly to Mother Nature. Your purchase makes a positive impact for wildlife and the environment. Their apparel is made ethically and with sustainable practices. So guys, go ahead and check out their online store at www.thegreatnorth.net, and to get 30% off on all products, go ahead and use the code ILONGME. That's ILONGGOME, no space in between. ILONGME, for you to get 30% off on all products. You're welcome. The links are down below. Okay guys, so that's it for this video about your Tillandsia Usneoides. I hope you learned something. If you want, you can start taking care of this beautiful, gorgeous plant. And if you have questions or suggestions or anything you'd like to add for this video, you can go ahead and place it in the comment section down below. Thank you so much again for watching this video, and I hope to see you on the next one.